Hey guys, it's PoxiiPro. Welcome back to another video. Today in Fallout 76, I'm going to be talking about caps. I went ahead and made a video about gold bullion and Scrip, so I figured I might as well cover the last main currency, which is caps. And this video is going to be much more brief since it's not as complicated as the other materials, but I still want to go ahead and give you guys all the details and knowledge around caps and just some recommendations from my experience. So first off, the maximum cap limit. We'll just talk about maximums. The maximum amount of caps that you can have on one character is going to be 30,000 caps. So you can have two characters each with 30,000 caps max. So it's not like an account based thing, but just per character. And you can only get a certain amount of caps per day in terms of selling to vendors before that resets. Each vendor is only going to have 1400 caps or 1400 caps to give to you for your products that you sell to them. Those are pretty much the hard caps in the game. And if you want to go ahead and ever check how many caps you have, you can always hit tab. We can just go here to effects, special collections, and right here we can see caps under all these other currencies. And yeah, so I have 1800 caps, which is a little bit more than half of the max total. And yeah, that's pretty much all the maximums, and that's how you check how many caps you have. I'm gonna go ahead and talk about like what you can use caps for and how you can gain caps. So you can gain caps in a couple different ways. I'll just go over a couple of the most common ways. You can gain caps by completing quests. You can gain caps by selling items to a vendor. You can gain caps by selling items through your camp vendor to like other players. You can gain caps by engaging in PvP. You can gain caps from teammates doing quests. You can gain caps in a lot of different ways. So I wouldn't be too worried about losing caps. You know, the maximum is pretty big and you generally can get a lot of caps. One of the biggest ways to get caps, in my opinion, is to have a water purifier, to have multiple water purifiers at a camp. And those are going to be the industrial ones, if you can. If you're not living near a water source, you're gonna have to use the smaller ones, but if you can, my camp's in construction, but if you can and you can fit these industrial water ones, like each of these produce a maximum of 5 before you need to take out of their inventory, and I have 5 of them, so that's 25 purified water. It is 20 caps each value, but then when you go to the vendor, it'll change depending on your charisma and whatnot, but it tends to add up. You can sell items that you loot through the world. You can pretty much sell anything and everything except like gold bullion items, and you can get a lot of caps that way. Let me go ahead and take you guys to a caps vendor. So let's just go to like a spring station, and there's lots of caps vendors everywhere. Every railroad or station is going to have a caps vendor. White Springs is going to have a vendor. There's going to be like vendors all around down here. There's going to be like various different vendors around the map, and they will all share the same cap inventory. So 1400, you know, across all vendors. But what they sell to you can be different. And right there, a teammate completed a quest, got some caps. And right there, now that I see it, you know, you can also use caps to fast travel. That's one of the main uses for caps, I would say, on a day-to-day basis, is fast traveling, because you're not going to usually walk across the entire map unless you like to. But generally, like once you have a lot of locations discovered, you're going to be fast traveling to different locations. The farther away, the more the caps. But traveling to your camp, traveling to a workshop you own, or a teammate's camp will have no cost. And certain places on the map, like the Foundation and Crater and Crater and Vault 76 will have no cap cost to fast travel to. And then events that can grant you gold bullion as a reward, or like the treasury notes, those events will have no cap cost to teleport to as well. So let's go ahead and teleport down to the spring station, and I'll show you guys how charisma kind of works. So when you're at a vendor, they're all going to be kind of like this, and you can just trade with them. I think there's a scorched beast outside. And we can go ahead, I'm just gonna go ahead and quickly demonstrate how charisma will affect your cap prices when you're buying and selling. But this is for non-player vendors, so only the NPC vendors. So if I go to trade for here, we'll use the purified water as an example. So this is only gonna sell for 3 caps per purified water. And you can see that this vendor has 336 caps left in their inventory, or for the day. And then this is how many caps I have at the bottom. And you can see all of their items, like their blood pack is going to be 44 caps, and this is per blood pack. So it's not going to be the 2 blood packs for 44, it's going to be 44 caps per blood pack. And you can go ahead and sort, you know, depending on what you're looking for. But let's go ahead and put on some perk cards that I like to use to help me when I'm shopping. These ones, Hard Bargain is a good one. So buying and selling prices at non-player vendors are now much better. And then on top of that, just having a higher charisma stat will help you in terms of price. So I like to put this on. Gain 2 charisma for each teammate, excluding yourself. So that's 2, 4, 6 extra charisma for having 3 other people on your casual team. And then plus Hard Bargain. Instead of, I think it was 3 caps, it is now 5 caps per purified water. So this 25 times 5, that's how many caps you'd get. So pretty much every time I do one harvest of my purified water, I get 125 caps. And I can stack a lot of purified water in just a playthrough, and eventually it starts racking up a bunch of caps. If you kill animals, cook their meat, and then sell it, that's another good way to get generate caps. Or if you loot weapons that you don't want to break down, you can sell those for caps. That's usually how I make all of my caps. And yeah, so you can see when you're buying things, like the blood pack is now 36 caps instead of I think it was 42. So overall, charisma is a good way to help boost your selling and buying power. A lot of the times, there's not that many use for caps, besides buying from vendors is pretty much the main use, and you can also buy gold bullion. If you have any questions on gold bullion, I'll go ahead and link a video in the description below, or if you are curious about the other currency, the legendary Scrip, I'll link a video in the description about that as well. Essentially, you can go over to the Wayward once a week, and it resets every Monday or Tuesday, I believe, and essentially you can buy 300 gold bullion per week at the cost of 6,000 caps, so that's a really good way to spend caps. My other preferred way is buying certain plans you might need from a vendor. So if you go here and you go to plans, they usually sell a lot of different plans. So if you're looking for like weapon mods, sometimes armor mods, you know, you can buy it from different vendors, or maybe even like power armor mods, that sort of thing. Different vendors will have those provided. A good set of vendors is at White Springs. They sell a large variety because there's a lot of different vendors there. My second favorite way to spend caps, or my other favorite way to spend caps, is actually to go to player vendors. If you hover over at player vendors, you can get a preview of what they're selling. I prefer to only travel to and buy from vendors that are on my team because their travel cost is free. So if I were to travel to this camp, completely free because they're on my team, travel to this camp, 28 caps. So if I am going to travel to somebody else's camp, generally what I'm looking for has to be worth it, or like the chance. Like let's say I'm really interested in ammo. This person has 2,000 rounds of ammo. Maybe it's worth the 28 caps to travel there. But let's say I'm interested in weapons. This guy only has 2 weapons. The odds that I like those weapons is kind of low, so I may not spend the caps to go there. So yeah, it kind of varies on your preference and how much caps you're willing to spend to devote to traveling. But I am in the market for some legendary weapons. So over here, I see this guy has 42 weapons. That's a pretty large quantity of weapons. So I'm willing to spend some caps to travel to and see if there's anything interesting. Oh, now that we are at this person's camp, we can go shopping and see if they have anything that's worth. And all of these prices are going to be unaffected by charisma. It is whatever price the player listed it at. I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how the vending machines actually work when you want to go ahead and set one up yourself. You just want to go ahead and enter the build mode for camps. And then we can go through here. And right here, you can just build a vending machine. But I think I already have one stored, so I'm going to use the stored one. Here we are. And you can see it just requires 3 power, and you can sell items from your stash, and you'll receive 90% of the sale price, and you'll lose 10% of it. So 1 power, your camp will appear on the map as a vendor. So I could, for example, just place this here, and then we can go ahead and interact with it to sell. And I can list anything I want here, so just for example, let's just say I want to list this ashtray. That's actually a good example of what not to do. So left clicking it will just take it out of your stash, but you want to actually use R to assign if you're on PC, or you'll see like whichever button you need on below. So we can assign this plan for the assault Tron head, and it's going to give you the estimated value, but a lot of the times this value is not what people use. It's kind of hard to gauge like what people would buy, so sometimes it takes a little bit of trial and error. If you're trying to sell like legendary weapons, I'll link a website in the description that can give you an estimate of what people would be willing to buy. Let's just say it's in high demand. I'm going to sell it for a bunch of caps. Boom. Right? And that's what I listed it at. And that's what it's going to be priced at. And then if I want, I can just cancel the sale. And if you have more than one of them, you can set the quantity of how much you want to sell, and then it takes you to the price. One big thing to note is never have items in your vending machine that will sell for enough caps to push you over the max. I hear a lot of stories of players having, like, let's say 20,000 caps, and they put like a really good legendary weapon, let's say for another 20,000 caps, somebody will buy that legendary and you will not get the difference because you only cap out at 30,000, right? So you'll lose 10,000 caps, but the player already bought the item. So you kind of just miss out. So always kind of calculate like how much is in your vending machine. That way you never cap out, because if you ever reach the maximum amount of caps, any caps earned after that will just be lost to the void. And then yeah, just to demonstrate that this is not powered, so if you look at my camp, it doesn't have the little vendor icon, but if somebody were to walk by and explore my camp, or if somebody teleported to my camp and they found the vending machine, they could still buy from it. So keep that in mind. If you don't want anybody buying from your vending machine, you have to store it, like manually store it in the build option, like that. That way nobody can buy from it. But if I did power it on, then it would actually appear on the map with a little icon that would look like this. But yeah, I don't think I really missed anything in the video. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please let me know in the comment section below. Any positive or negative feedback, also let me know. That way I can improve. But yeah, I really hope I didn't miss any details. And if you have any further questions about caps or anything that I may have missed, feel free to ask and I'll try to answer to the best of my ability. Other than that, until next time.